I want to take you to just something I saw out of the Wall Street Journal. It's in the paper this morning, our time, Monday morning for the Wall Street Journal. And effectively it comes off the back of very strong jobs numbers on Friday, which again here. Now, doubts creep in about a Fed rate cut this year. Remembering, of course, the Fed has given every indication there could be three interest rate cuts this year. So this is what you and I have been talking about for a long, long time. But it's not just an Australian story. This is a global story.
Yeah, and this is really the worst case for the RBA, who have not taken their interest rate up anywhere near the level of the US. And the Fed is now sort of backtracking on signaling of cuts. They haven't dismissed the idea, as we know from public statements and their dot plot. But of course, the data keeps rolling in stronger than expected. That payrolls number on Friday night was exceptionally strong. And there's a clear improving trend in US employment. And of course, the unemployment rate is no longer going up in the US. So the US economy seems to be in recovery. The soft landing was a 2023 story. And the evidence as it's coming through in the last month or so here in Australia is that we seem to be following suit. We're about 6 months behind them. And of course, with our interest rate a full percentage point below the Fed in the US, not only does rate cuts look distant, this starts to bring in the question of the need potentially for rate hikes should inflation stay higher than desired here in Australia.
All right, because there are a few things here. You note the survey today. Small business appears to be recovering. Conditions are recovering. Big business seems to have already been there. We've seen the unemployment rate falling in February. You start to see inflation remains stubbornly higher above the trend. These, as you point out, are all signs of recovery, not signs of hardship, which would cause interest rate cuts.
That's right. And I don't think there's any doubt that there are pockets of the economy that are going through quite a lot of financial stress, whether that's in household or businesses, but they're pockets and they're quite small. What the data is showing us is households overall are still okay because they have jobs, I think is the most important feature. And of course, businesses, despite rising insolvencies, actually have pretty strong balance sheets and are investing and borrowing still. So look, this really is a tricky situation, but certainly the momentum appears to be shifting away from rate cuts and potentially towards rate hikes. Certainly the bond market is moving in that direction with US long-term interest rates moving up to three-month highs.
I'll tell you what, Warren Hogan, always good to have you in the program, and many thanks for your time today.
Thanks, Ross.